optically concentrated samples. Question. How can we study concentrated samples without diluting? Realistically, you can't, not using electrophoretic light scattering. Other techniques exist, such as electrokinetic sonic amplitude, ESA. Question. If we reduce the gap between the electrodes, can it be a solution to study concentrated samples? No, but it is a solution to study high salt concentration samples and nonpolar samples. In both cases, it's because it allows a smaller voltage to be used to generate the same electric field used with other cells, such as the folded capillary. Question. Most of the ELS instruments use forward scattering. If we use backscattering to study the concentrated samples, will it be possible to avoid peak broadening? Backscattering is used for particle sizing by dynamic light scattering. In backscattering mode, the instrument looks at light scattered from randomly moving particles close to the cuvette wall on the same face as the incident light. This means there is minimal chance of multiple scattering, the cause of peak broadening. Electrophoretic light scattering looks at the particle motion between the electrodes in the center of the cuvette. For a concentrated sample, the incident laser will almost certainly undergo multiple scattering even before it reaches the center. The scattered light will suffer as well. All commercial instruments use the so-called reference beam configuration. My original PALS instrument uses the crossed beam configuration, which is immune to multiple scattering. As long as the light can get through the sample, it can be analyzed. Question. How much should we dilute the samples? A very good question with a fairly simple answer. Hariba has a very nice guide on this subject that you can get at the link shown at the bottom. This is for particle sizing via dynamic light scattering, but the concept is the same for zeta potential using electrophoretic light scattering from the same instrument. Just consider zeta potential instead of z-average diameter. The idea here is to simply make measurements over a range of dilutions, typically a series of twofold dilutions. You want to choose a dilution that puts you in the flat part of the response graph. Ignore the red line since it is specific for particle sizing, not zeta potential measurement. You also want to pick a dilution that has the lowest variability for repeated measurements. In this case, you can see the flat response spans more than 1.5 decades. But what do these samples look like? Is there a quick way to eyeball the desired dilution? Yes, it's sometimes called the newsprint test. This picture is pretty self-explanatory. You can also shine a laser pointer through the sample. If it's too dilute, you won't see the beam. If it's too concentrated, the beam will glow or simply not pass through at all. With experience, you'll be able to gauge dilution easily. It does depend on the instrument and the type of sample, especially particle size. Your instrument's manual should provide a guide. Also, the concentration affects the count rate, the strength of the scattered signal. There's a recommended range of count rates. Again, check your instrument's manual. Although the concepts are the same between vendors, the recommended values may differ.